If it's May 18th, 2012, it must be Ellenburg. It must be Northern Adirondack Central School. It must be the FFA Ag Fair. Calvin and I have been regular fixtures here for a few years, and it's because we love it. We talk to kids, we talk to teachers, we even hear an occasional cow moo. It's an event that our North Country people are anxious to see every year because it's a dwindling group. There aren't as many family farms, there aren't as many schools with ag programs anymore. So this has been kind of a flagship for us to bring our hometown cable cameras down here every year. A little different venue because over at the school, the elementary school here, Northern Adirondack, they're doing construction. You can see the trailers, the equipment all over the place. So lots of people are walking through the tennis courts to get over here on a field where some of the,
high school.
Huh?
That's the high school.
Oh, that's the high school, yeah. The elementary school is over Kelvin's left shoulder. Sorry about that. But this is a little different venue over in the field behind here this year. You can see the tent set up. There are tractors. There is farm equipment of all kinds. It's right next to the ball fields. There are some extra events that we haven't seen in previous years. Of course, there's face painting. There are people here with crafts and lots of kids from Northern Adirondack and surrounding areas. Farm families and their kids are here showing their various cattle, the small cattle there. We saw chickens and rabbits and who knows what all. And last year, I understand in the state fair, this group I think won something like 36 ribbons. I may be wrong, but we'll find out later as we interview some of the participants. So stay with us for the Ag Fair, the FFA Ag Fair at Northern Adirondack Central School. Just in case Calvin didn't get a shot of the sky.
It's pretty beautiful.
Oh my gosh, what a wonderful day. Don Jones, how are you?
I'm very good.
I'm so glad to see you. I understand
you. Know what? It was a little dicey.
You did a good job with your little belly and you got it going again. Had that little tumor removed and
I got a second chance.
You're
of
good
life.
To go for another 50 or 60 years.
Hoping so.
I love
hoping
it. So this is, looks like a good program this year.
It is. We have the 50th annual. School fair.
Is it 50th annual?
Yep. I found that out when I was reading the Press Republican. Donna Primo's like, did you see the section where they go back 50 years?
It says was it in there?
It said 50 years ago, and Monday was the first school fair.
Oh, isn't that fantastic?
Yep.
So I heard a couple of days ago that you're moving out of here and you're trying to get back to your hometown.
I'm trying. It's 100 miles and it's a lot. And 100 miles each way is a little intense. I'm on my second vehicle. I totaled one this winter coming up.
Did you really?
Yeah.
It was in the ditch?
I slid across the road, hit a guardrail, set off the airbags, couldn't see what I was doing, threw a snowbank, you know, and it took me about a month and a half to get my car back. So, but everything lucked out, you know. It all works out.
You had a new baby.
We did.
A month ago today.
Yep. So his name is Ethan Thomas, and he's got
April
a seven-year-old.
April 18th?
Yep.
Ethan Thomas.
Yeah.
Ethan Thomas.
So he's got a big brother, Connor Michael, who's seven.
Oh, congratulations, Donald. That's what makes life really worthwhile.
Yeah. And, you know, that's part of the, it's a tough decision, you know, to leave.
Yeah.
But being 100 miles away, and I want to be there for my kids and go to their soccer games. And
I don't know how people can commute that far. Fortunately, I've never had to commute more than 10 or 15 minutes from where I worked, and I like that.
Well, I used to have a truck, and when the price of gas started going up, I was paying more in gas than a new car payment. So I went down to Phil's and got a nice little cruise, and works out pretty well for me.
That's
I miss
wonderful.
My truck though. Don't get me
so
wrong.
So you're done after this year.
This
you're
is
on
it.
Your way.
June 22nd, I'm done, and
you got some ideas. Maybe.
You know, still, well, there's always the Navy, you know. So I talked to the recruiter, and you never know what's going to happen. So
Karen Lombard is going to take over the ag program.
They went through the selection process, and she's actually in the booth over there.
We'll get the chat
show.
With her.
Oh yeah, I'll make sure we get to everybody.
Is she a local woman?
She's local. She grew up on a family farm around here, and
see that?
She moved away and got some experience on other schools, and it's time for her to come home.
You know, while we have a chance, there are always a few people who haven't seen this program before. Mm-hmm. They don't know there are ag programs that still exist in schools.
This is the sole one in Clinton County.
Think about it.
Yep, and there's a few more that are coming online and a few more that are closing because of the budget crisis, but there's about 70 programs across the state. That's about it. And our kids do extremely well, you know, that go through the ag program and the FFA and everything with, you know, getting out there and getting it done and competing on a national level where they're required to go through it in other schools, in other states.
Isn't that amazing to me? Yeah. And I read online this morning, Calvin knew it already, that you had some state and national honors last year.
We did. We had 2 years ago, we had Tyler Nephew. He went and came first in the state for the dairy showmanship.
Yeah.
This year we had Matt Carter won first in the state for dairy showmanship. They both got rides to nationals. They got a little check to help them get there. And they both competed and did very well. Matt Carter got a gold in last year.
That's not hard to take, huh?
Not hard. It's a long trip, but it's definitely worth the ride. Alden Kerr, who's showing cows over here, actually won first place in the state for the meats contest. You know, it's something that's a little bit different, but...
What does that involve? I don't know about that.
Meats contest was my bread and butter when I was
in
FFA. Yeah. See, I grew up in Connecticut, and that was part of our thing, so you need to know all the primal cuts, all the retail cuts, how to grade meat, how to mix it to get a certain fat percentage. But a lot of the way you do it is the same way you mix rations with dairy cows. So it's all the same procedure.
Isn't that interesting? So let's talk a little bit more about the ag program itself. What does it involve for kids?
Opportunities. Part of it is you're going to have a job experience where it's called a supervised ag experience program. We try to get as many kids to do that, and for most of these kids, it's showing cows. It's something that they either grow up on the farm or they've got experience. I got another young man that he doesn't know it yet, but we're going to put him in Giroux Brothers working here and there.
Oh, really?
He wants to go for the Cobalt School for diesel mechanics in a couple of years, so we were trying to get him in there ahead of time so he can get threaded through the program. You know, we got all these tractors. It's opportunities that these kids don't get anywhere else, you know. Granted, sometimes they drive them around a little too fast, but...
So what grade do they start in?
For the senior FFA, it's 9 through 12. We have the junior FFA, which we start in fifth grade.
Fifth grade?
So even before they come over here, they know what it's about. You know, they have a good understanding. We have monthly meetings with them. Granted, the junior meetings aren't like the senior meetings. You know, sometimes we do a lot more fun stuff. We make butter, you know, instead of just having a formal meeting. We work with the animals, play games, but it's getting them involved before they get up here so they have a thorough understanding of what it is. You know, one of the guys that's in the ring right now, there's probably two or three of them that are in fifth grade, and they've been waiting for 3 years to be able to show up.
Isn't that just great? I just love it.
And they've been at the county fair, and at the county fair we started a new level of showmanship called Little Britches. And it's for those little kids that are just...
Bridges?
Yeah, because, you know, our show is for FFA members. So in order to be an official FFA member, it's 5th grade through 12th grade. And then as you go through, parents are there and the cows are there. So they wanted to experience too. So we started a class called Little Britches, just for kids that are just a little too young.
You know, for those people watching this in metropolitan areas and in other countries, we just want you to know that the rural life is still alive and well in the northeastern corner of New York State.
It's
here. These kids are so anxious to be here. Look at the little ones all lined up. They were.
Oh yeah.
There must have been 50 waiting to get their faces painted over there in the corner.
We got. I mean, it's just awesome. It's a whole thing where the whole school gets involved. You
know? Isn't it great?
It is amazing.
We saw some of the crafts that the kids had made. We're looking at everything from jars and flower container vases and other things they were making. We saw some woodwork that some other people had made over on the side.
On the side over here, there's a young man by the name of Chris Washburn, and he's doing hand carvings out of bark.
Beautiful.
It's something his dad showed him how to do, and then he goes through and does it, and he's got them here to sell. He's like, can I set up a table? I'm like,
of course you can. My mouth dropped open as I,
and that
was so funny. The way I started the day very early this morning, probably about the same time you got up, Calvin sent me something involving a painter who started painting when he was 11 years old, and he painted mostly rural scenes.
Mm-hmm.
And it was, your mouth starts to drop open as you look at these paintings. They look like photographs.
Yeah, they're stunning.
Beautiful paintings of little children and big children and gardens and cows and old-fashioned milking parlors and machines. And Robert Duncan is his name. Calvin remembers names. I don't. But there were maybe 50 paintings on this website, and I had seen some of them before, but not all of them. So it was a good way to start the day. Listen to the music, Kay and I sipping our coffee and looking at the at what rural life is like. And you know what? It's the backbone of our country.
It is. It's where we started, and it's where we got to be to survive. I mean, we feed the world, and it's just the way it goes. When everybody's in a problem, humanitarian aid comes from this country.
Yeah. Are all the kids in that Northern Adirondack allowed to come here today?
At some point when they have a study hall, they can just come out anytime they want. A lot of the teachers, because they know they're just looking out the window, just make arrangements to bring them out anyway, you know.
Of course.
Instead of just kind of having them all look out the window all the time. But the administration is unbelievably supportive of this program. The Board of Ed, we got a Board of Ed member over there with horses. Paul Gilmore's over there.
Paul and his horses. I saw him a few minutes ago.
And just the support for this is unbelievable.
Well, Don, I want to thank you for all of your support for this program, for all you've done for a lot of different reasons in the North Country. And more than that, I want to wish you good fortune in your endeavors. The next chapter of your life is about to unfold.
Yep.
Sometimes it's good that we don't know what's happening tomorrow.
It makes it a little bit more of an adventure. And for me, I almost thrive on that adventure.
Yeah.
But that drives my wife nuts sometimes.
It's going to be a good chapter for you. We wish you luck with that. We're going to take a walk around and talk to people.
Thank you very much.
Thank you, Donald. I think it's a buzz cut, don't you? Homer Bushy doing a little job right here. And he looks like he's done it before. He's kind of a pro. He's the one that started the ag program here a long, long time ago. I think he's the one that started it, and it's been worked out very well. Yeah, Calvin is still here. So we're watching what's going on behind the scene here, and the cattle are really quite nice. We want to talk a little bit more about the kids from the Northern Adirondack Central School, this FFA and this ag program that go on to become state champions and even win gold medals in national competition, if you can believe that. So we're pretty proud of the teachers, the program sponsors, the school administrators, and of course the kids themselves. And today I think you'll get an idea as we walk through and talk to folks just how marvelous this program is and what it means to kids to come up through this program, because it bodes well for what happens to them throughout their entire lifetimes.
All right, Gordy, we're going to have something to look at here very shortly, but Homer did not start it here. Our buddies from the Hemingford Apple there,
Come on now. Oh, nice people too.
Yes, yes.
And one or two of them might even survive.
No,
now,
I think they're both gone.
Oh, they're really gone?
And I wish I could remember his name, and I certainly
remembered
it for a long time.
15 years ago or so.
Yeah, yeah. He's the one who started it, and it was an offshoot, and of course, NAC hasn't been here for 50 years, so I'm not sure what article Don Jones was referring to. But NAC, of course, was started in the 70-71 school year. So I don't know if
it was Ellenburg before that.
Ellenburg,
the school
and
centralized.
Altona and Lion Mountain. So I think Homer, a graduate of Altona, I think there was an ag program in Altona, and I think there was a program here in Ellenburg. So between them, one of them maybe started 50 years ago. Homer, I'm sure, would know because that's about the time he graduated. So,
well, it's great to have Mayor. We'll get to chat with him before this day is finished, that's for sure. All right, we're underway again. Here's the master mechanic, the guy who knows how to wield those shears. Homer Bushy, how are you?
Oh, not too bad.
What another perfect day?
I wish I could have had that as many days as I was there, but a lot of times it was a little bit different type of weather conditions, but I guess they were saved somewhat from a couple of days ago when we had that downpour that came through. And
I'm just so delighted. Yeah. The weatherman shines down on us today for another one of the ag fairs. Yeah. You've been associated with many. We're trying to talk with Don about the history And you began in the 70s.
Yeah. Started July 1 in 1970.
But you went to Altona before the schools were centralized.
Right.
And there was an ag program in Altona.
But I didn't start in Altona teaching. I went to high school there.
Yeah. But there was an ag program.
Right. Charlie Patch was the ag teacher that was there at the time.
Those people who might remember way back when, I think it must be close to 15 years ago, when we went up to Hemingford. 99 or 2000, and talked to the Petch boys at their orchard up there, and right. It was one of the great times of my life. You and I both remember them as great people.
Great
nice
people.
Nice people.
Yeah. Both Bob and Charlie both passed on now, but yep. I believe Bob's son has taken over the orchard.
Oh, really?
Yes, I thought.
Haven't been there since that day. So the program started here then in the early 70s.
Right.
And did it grow from nothing to something, or how did that work?
No, the programs were pretty well intact with, you know, the, you know, good kids in the program. And we're just continuing to, you know, to carry on with the tradition that's been in the past. And once in a while, enrollments sometimes are a little bit difficult to maintain. A lot of times it's mainly because state education department requires the kids to get involved into more academic classes. And if the kids weren't up to par, then there were some difficult times to get them to put them into it. And then the realization of agriculture, some parents might have, you know, difficulty at the time deciding whether they would want their child to take ag, thinking that, you know, I'm not sure if it was a situation where ag wasn't as meaningful as what some of the other courses were. But I think through the years it got to a point where what was there got just a little better than what it was, and we ended up with a great, unbelievable bunch of kids that we had.
Do you think it's meaningful? That's why we come back every year for this program, just to watch the kids having a good time. The
yes.
kids with their cattle here today. You couldn't stay away if you wanted to, could you, Homer?
Well, I kind of hard because I got four of mine up here.
I still got
a young man up here that's a senior this year, but we've got a couple animals here too, but I'm sure I'd probably be up here anyway, helping the kids out as much as I can, helping out.
I like it over on this side. They moved the whole thing over here from behind the school.
Well, the main reason is because the construction is going on, right?
It's nice over here.
I was already talking with Mr. Loffman about what the conditions might be for another year, because of now all the different propane gas that's over there. That's basically where some of the tents were put up in the vicinity of that. So it's just almost impossible to probably do that again. But he'd like to see it back here again, if indeed we do continue with this, which I'm sure we will. Push it back a little bit further, so he would like to take and maybe expose more of the smaller animals on the other exhibits up front first, and then have the cattle situation in the back, so that it provides more opportunity, especially for the elementary school that brings all their little kids over here. It's much safer having it over here having to taking and bring them through the parking lot to see the
I agree, yeah.
exhibit.
I was surprised when I parked over there and walked across on the tennis courts this morning.
Well, very significantly is the fact that there's more cattle here this year than what there was last year.
Oh, there are.
So there's got to be obviously more kids that are being involved with the program. Whole different situations occurring for another year with the program, and I don't see anything other than anything positive that's going to be happening with this program for years to come. So I'm very excited about what's going to be happening, and the kids' involvement with the Alumni Association that I put together 4 years ago. It's sort of a backing for the program, and it helps the community know what the program's all about, as well as the administration and the faculty of the school. So indeed, if the program gets back in full swing, I'm sure we'll hopefully see this thing continue on.
Tell me a little bit about the judging for people who don't live on farms and don't know much about agriculture. What do they judge?
Well, the first thing they do is the kids are taught to their parents or to a teacher or to someone that's involved with showing dairy cattle how to present the animal the best to show how well it exhibits the dairy characteristics of that particular breed. And this is what they do first. It's basically getting an animal well prepared for showmanship class. You compete against the other kids to see how well better your animal's prepared and how well you can present that animal better than the other child or person that's in that ring with them. It's no men versus the women. It's everybody. It's a situation where both boys and girls are involved in the contest, and that's basically what it is, showmanship. This class is going to be the last class. We've been very fortunate that we've had some families that have been involved in pursuing some of these kids to continue on and showing animals, and one of the competitions that they have at the State Fair in Syracuse is a dairy handlers contest. They don't have to prepare the animal, but they have to exhibit the animal to the kids that are judging the dairy cattle judging contest at the State Fair. And the last 2 years in a row, Northern Adirondack's won both of them.
No kidding.
Tyler and nephew won it the year before, and Matt Carter won it the past year. Both of them went on to the Nationals. They both received outstanding awards for their accomplishments. And it goes to show you that, you know, the livelihood of agriculture with dairy and this community is still as strong as ever. And these kids will be competing today, and these two gentlemen here will be competing today in this one contest with other kids that are in the same age group for Master Showman. And it's just a continuation of that one particular part of the dairy cattle show that we have here today. The other part is the confirmation class. The confirmation classes are based upon how well the animal is according to its breed and to what its character is supposed to be. The dairiness of it, for instance, how well the udder is attached, how well the feet and legs are on the animal for strength and continuation, longevity. And they start with the heifer classes. They do have a young bull class, but I don't believe there's any here. But they start with spring calves that are born after the 1st of March. And then classes proceeding in like 3 or 4 or 5 months intervals, all the way till they get to the senior yearlings, which are somewhere in the vicinity of anywhere from 18 to 24 months. And at that point, they'll select the overall the best one of the classes that are in there, and they identify that as a junior champion. Then they give a second place ribbon to the person who comes in second, and that's called a reserve junior champion. Then when the next part of the class is the confirmation of the dairy cows, and that's of course cows that are milking, or in some cases cows that are dry also, they have dry cow classes. And they're based upon the total outlook of that particular animal. Everything that you can imagine, that animal's body, that makes it a true animal, and also the fact that it's an animal that obviously is going to be very productive, and what it's supposed to be doing is, of course, making milk. And then when they get done with that, they have an overall championship for the milking cows, and it's reserve senior champion, and then the senior champion. Then when they get done with this, they have their grand champion and reserve grand champion, and they take the two senior champions and the two junior champions and bring them into the ring. And in most cases, the senior champions are going to get the grand and reserve grand champions because the heifers don't have an udder developed on them to see actually what their potential is. So it also ends up being the cows with the udders that get the grand and reserve grand champion.
And some of the kids who are here don't go to Northern Adirondack, right? Do most of them?
Oh, no, they all go to Northern Adirondack.
I thought maybe we had a few imports from surrounding schools that don't
we
have
did. We did. We did back in the 90s, late 90s. We had some.
Oh,
we
you
had
did?
Some, we had them when I was here. We had kids from Northeastern Clinton, and we had kids from Beatontown.
Yeah.
And it was great, unfortunately, and the funding just all wasn't there. I mean, I think at the time it was a great deal for those kids to come up because the tuition wasn't very much at all to come up here. The only problem was, of course, bus transportation to get them back and forth. But I had some great kids, all of them, and the ones that I know that are out in the field that I've had that are very successful in what they're doing. Mike Parker, for instance, and Washazi.
There you go, Michael.
And I had a young man from Beatontown that was a great kid. Went to Colba Skill and helped his dad on the farm, and unfortunately was working for a construction company and then got killed in a car accident, Eric Pellerin.
Oh, yeah.
Great, great boy. And, you know, just on top of the kids' names, I got a couple boys that work for the County Highway Department, Josh Rebidou and Brian LaFountain. You couldn't ask for better kids than that. Very, very intelligent construction-wise. Those guys can build a two-story home and unbelievable construction technology they have. When we were revamping the ag room, we had to check out the tool room and my office that I had there because there wasn't enough room. I had to have more room for the kids. So we built a room with concrete blocks, and I had those kids that we did a covered unit of concrete block construction, and those boys are the ones that helped put that,
isn't
that wall
that amazing?
Up. Yeah. And so
that's their legacy, and it's still over there.
And it's still over there.
Well, it's good. This program, that's what I wanted to point out before we're finished. It's good for kids.
Oh, yeah.
It's good for the rest of their lives, lessons that you can't learn anywhere else.
Well, the thing that you also got to remember is the FFA is a very integral part of the program, which the leadership development that these kids get, if indeed this program is carried the way it's been in the past, we get parliamentary procedure. These kids know parliamentary law. They can go in a business meeting and chair a meeting or be an individual that can participate and know what needs to be done and be able to carry out the way motions are supposed to be done in the meeting. We've had state winners. We've gone to the Nationals with parliamentary law. Public speakers, prepared public speaking, extemporaneous public speaking. I've had state winners. I've had two girls. One of them had hearing deficiency. And then she was only, she was a junior that year. She went out for extemporaneous. She got to the state level. She won the state level. And in addition to that, she went for the run for the state office of the treasurer. And in her nominating speech, she told about being disabled. And, you know, the impact on her life. She got elected.
Don't you love it?
And you see that, you know, the progression of those kids as they come up. You know, when you start them in fifth grade, like I've done in the past, it's just a progression of how well they achieve and do as well as they do when they get on in their own life.
Yeah. It's great to watch it all happen, to see the little kids become big kids, go out in the world and come back and say, thanks, Mr. Bushy. Well, you know, when you can touch a few lives like that, it makes a difference in your own life as you grow older.
And they respect you for that. I mean, I got guys that are 50 years old still calling me Mr. Bushy.
Don't you love it?
I'm a little bit older now, but I'm also old as Calvin.
You're even older than me.
Yeah. Well, it's a good program. We're going to go around, talk to some people, and see what we can see in this beautiful, sunshiny day in May.
Beautiful day.
Homer, thanks so much.
No problem. Anytime.
You're the man.
Oh, I don't know about that, but...
Yeah, you're the man.
Take care.
I don't mind talking, it's just I don't
know what to ask. Yeah, I always ask the hardest questions. Paul Gilmore, how are you?
Good.
Last time we were here, you were going to get started on the school board.
Yes, I did.
And what's that been
like? First year under.
How is it?
I really enjoy it.
Do you really?
I really enjoy it. It takes some time. I've had to go for training. Very interesting, very... I'm still excited. I've been in a year and I'm still excited.
You know, a lot of school board members are getting a little discouraged these days.
You're always discouraged when you're talking money and someone's job. But I mean, as far as being part of academics and this right here is exciting.
I've always told people, don't complain unless you're willing to wear the cloak.
There you go.
Get involved in your school board.
There you go.
And in the last couple of years, it's been really tough for many school board members because of those decisions. And they take grief from about four different sides.
Yeah.
You're a big guy, so this runs off your back pretty easy, Paul.
No, I'm not going to say it just runs off my back, because you might have to ask that question to my wife, because there's a lot of nights where, you know.
If you take it seriously, it is tough.
Yep.
You have to think about it. But it's a good school organization that you have up here.
Yes, it is.
That's why we keep coming back every year, and especially for this program. The first thing I saw when I got out of my car was your horses.
Oh, yeah?
I said, I know Paul's here.
Yeah. I bring them over for my niece and the neighbor kids right here.
Talk a little bit about your horses.
What do you want to know? Same pair I had last year. Duke, 11-year-old Belgian. Pat, 21-year-old Percheron. I have them because I like to pull with them, but we have them as family pets. We hook them up, we'll go for a sleigh ride, we'll hook them up, and we just enjoy them.
You know, I'm in the process of reading a book now about lumbering in the northeastern states and New England and New York State way back in the 1700s and 1800s, and how much work those people could do with horses and oxen before the age of machinery, and how a just unbelievable story that we think about in legends.
What do they call that? It's low impact logging with horses, and you're seeing a lot more of it now in the western part, like Ohio, western United States. Then actually there's New Hampshire. They're still doing it there. A lot of landowners that don't want the skidder ruts. There's teams out there, there's people out there that still do it today.
I think there are people watching this show who don't live in rural areas, who have never seen horses up close like this, especially beautiful horses like yours, and they have no idea what a horse can pull.
No, they don't. It still amazes me, and I've only been in it 6-7 years now. And if I was to hook them to what we use in a pulling contest, cement.
Yeah.
Cement. Him and his mate, 5 years ago, won in New Hampshire.
Come on.
They won the roundup. I didn't own them then, but I'm trying to remember how much weight was on there. And if I was to say 9,000 pounds, 10,000 pounds, And these are small horses. This is that's a small horse for his for being a Belgian. He's 1880. He weighs 1880 pounds.
We've seen some big Belgians, yeah.
And we can go down the road. I can show you a couple 2,500 pound ones.
Isn't that amazing?
Unbelievable.
You know, and they still do horse pulling at the county fair.
Plattsburgh Fair does it. Yeah. We have a big horse. Can I like throw out a little jab for our?
Oh yeah.
We have a horse club here in this area, and the guy that started our horse pulls in Lime Mountain, Harry Frenier, when he passed away last year. We started the Harry Frenier Memorial Horse Pull.
Did you really?
We had one in Lime Mountain last year.
That.
And our second annual Harry Frenier Memorial Horse Pull is July 14th at the Lime Mountain American Legion.
Isn't that wonderful?
Yeah.
Most people remember Harry for his athletic prowess on the ball field because we played balls together years and years ago, he and his brother. But I didn't realize he was into the horses.
He's the one that got me into it.
No kidding.
He's the one that got me into it. That was his original team when he moved to Chattagay Lake. I don't know how many years ago it was. He was part of it, the old gray.
You develop a certain affinity with horses, and you love them when you work with them every day.
Yes, you do.
And it's hard to explain. Look at this. How's that for a smile? Huh? I love that.
A little cold water there.
Yeah, look at this.
Just he's performing for the camera. He's
hamming it up for the camera.
Yeah.
So how old is he?
11 years old.
He's 11. Yeah. And they how long do they live?
I don't know. A little bit of research. I've done it 30, 35 years. Is, you know, being bigger horses, too, you don't know how that wears on their hearts and indigestion, the insides and stuff, you know.
Do you still work with them?
Yeah.
You do every day or often?
Just about every day. During the summer, spring, summer, fall. You know, we're on a sled, we're walking.
You know, among my, and Calvin and I have talked about the old stone boat. Yeah. How many times in the fields have we hauled stone on the stone boat with horses? Not that it's a very pleasant memory for me as a young kid. But some of my fondest memories are of going to the county fairs many, many, many years ago when I was a little boy and watching the horse pulling contests and watching the difference between how certain owners treat their horses. Some rough and some gentle, you know, that many years later the horse whisperer came along.
Yeah.
But if you treat your horses right, they'll do almost anything you want them to do. If they can.
Yeah, it's just like anything else, you know.
Do you have more than two?
We have one more at home.
One more at home?
Yeah, he was new this year, and although he's not wild or nothing, you know, small pen, put three big horses in there for an all day, you know, they might not. That fence isn't really holding them there. That's just, you know. If he picked his head up, he'd pick that fence up. You know,
he could do whatever he wanted to when he wanted to do it.
I'd like to say I could hold him, but I know I can't. But I can hold him good, you know.
You know, when you're just talking about that, you put me in mind of Melissa Monte Provost at Country Dreams Farm. She had a big team called Pat and Pete. And we were filming one day, and old George was saying, these are the mildest-mannered horses you've ever seen. You can walk between their hind legs, and they'd never move. So we hooked them up to the wagon, started down. Calvin, I'm up on the front seat with Melissa. Calvin's on the back, standing up, filming. All of a sudden, we're going through the lane through a gate, and we heard this loud report. I thought somebody shot us. Those horses took off. Calvin's on his back shooting sky, feet, birds. And fortunately, he survived, and we all survived. And Melissa just whispered to the horses and got them stopped. And we found out later, blew a tire on the wagon.
Oh,
you use old tires on your wagon, blew a tire. Yeah.
And you that's probably why the Amish use steel tires.
You think that's it? Anyway, I think of that every time we talk about horses going a little crazy because they can get spooked at every now and again. But you got a wonderful group here.
Yeah, you can. No matter how well-mannered you are or think they are, there's always that chance that something could spook them.
Yeah, so you have to be careful because they're big, strong animals. We can't say enough about the school system down here. And my highest compliments to you for even thinking about running for the school board. I think it's great. In this day and age, it's a tough thing to do.
Yeah, it is. We face tough decisions this year, and
You know, everybody did. Every school, every budget passed except Plattsburgh, right?
Correct.
We're doing this on May 18th, 2012, and it's tough. Now they got to go again in Plattsburgh.
Yeah,
we've been through that many times with all of our schools. And you know, people say, "What programs do you want to go?" Well, we don't want any of them to go if we can keep them. But it's so hard.
No, you know, and first thing they look at is sports.
Of course.
You know, and
having been involved in athletics, we understand the importance, you know, in the lives of our own kids and our families. So it's really, really hard. So you go to
then you weigh the sports to a program like this.
Yeah.
You know, then it's almost, you know, well, okay. It's tough decisions.
There are some people who are surprised that the ag program has gone on this many years. And we hope it goes on far into the future, but the future is unknown. Yeah. It looks to me like we had an even bigger turnout this year than we did last year.
I think as far as cows and
more
cattle,
cows?
I believe so. I believe so, yeah. I mean, we had smaller calves over there. I didn't make it in. I don't usually make it inside when they were hosting it over on the blacktop to see what, as far as small animals, but there's some here.
We got them here, and we're happy to be here, Paul. You're the man. I didn't ask you too many hard questions.
No, you didn't.
Have a great day, and thanks for bringing your horses, and thanks for all you do.
Yeah, I try.
At the place of the class, though, to me, there was kind of a tight pair on top of the class, and our young man with his big Holstein cow today maybe just had a slight edge in terms of making sure that animal that he was at the halter of, no matter whether we changed animals or not, maybe just a touch advantage today in getting that animal presented right at all times. Our young man in second with this Swiss heifer, excellent job. I mentioned that maybe sometimes like to see those front legs just a little more square when he stands the animal. But again, very close placing. Our young man with the jersey, a very stylish heifer that's maybe a little squirrely today, maybe doesn't hold that neck as straight as what we'd like to see, but he has definitely worked with her and has done an outstanding job of presenting her. And our young man and our young lady down here with the Holsteins, again, outstanding job. Just some things in terms of getting those heads up and making sure they're as alert as maybe a couple of the kids at the top of the class. But again, to me, there's not a last place in the class. But again, let's show our appreciation for an outstanding group of young showmen.
We just recorded the senior showman, but now, like you said, this is the big enchilada.
This is the big enchilada. This is the master right here. So you have the best two of each classes that we've already had come out and for the big shindig here.
I'm amazed at the poise that these kids have.
Yeah,
and it's a tribute to the program. I'm sure it is.
It takes time, and a lot of it is. This is a lot of the stuff they've got to learn somewhere else within the classroom. We can give them the fundamentals, but I don't know if the last time I looked at my class, I don't have cows in there, you know. So this is a tribute to the community. This is, you know, their parents. This is their aunts and uncles and friends and all supporting this program.
So who's the judge?
His name is Jerry Emmerich. He's a breeder for Sire Select.
Oh, he is?
Yep. And he's been international judging. So I didn't totally know that, but when we got talking a little bit more to feel him out, he's been to Panama, Costa Rica.
Wow.
And judging and, genetics that he does with Sire Select. But he's very good, and the one reason I really like him is he's good with the kids.
He's wonderful. We recorded that his last speech at the end of the last class.
That's the
way he talks to the kids makes them feel good about what they've accomplished.
And if you look at him, you can tell some of them are more intense on themselves, and we go over talking through it.
Who else is out there, kids?
Well, we've got over there. We got Austin Trombley on the side. Behind him, the Holstein, we've got Caleb Sample. I think that's Tyler, the great big cow back there. And behind him we have Matt Breyer. Matt Nephew is right around the corner over here, followed by Alexis Kerr. And they're all real good.
So these animals have all been judged at least once today?
These are all the winners from the last three rounds.
Oh. So
this is animals or showmanship?
This is showmanship here, but the animals that they're working with is the best. The best. All the kids have been in here.
Kids are being
judged on this one. Sorry. In the showmanship, the kids are being judged on how they show the animals. So they get to pick their animal, they get to work with it. The confirmation class, which is after this, is the actual animal itself. The animals are judged.
Well, most of these kids have had several years' experience, right?
Yeah.
Or some of them.
If you look, Tyler's the one there with the Holstein. He's been doing this since he was in fifth grade. He's a senior.
Oh, really?
He won states last year at the state fair. Goes to nationals. He gets a silver emblem at the state. Let's see. Behind him, Matt Breyer. Matt Breyer's been going to the county fair with me at least for 3 years. He went down to states all by himself last year. Took his own animals down and everything. Alexis has been involved when we're at the county fair. She does the junior britches. Austin's been involved for a while now. I think he's been showing in the junior FFA for 2 years. Colby, since fifth grade, and I think he's in ninth now. So they got some time. They got some ring time.
So just give us a little idea of some of the fine points of what this judge is looking for.
Confidence. He's looking for the way the animal responds. Is it trained? Does it set up right? Are the feet right so they can judge it? Does the neck look long? You know, does he present that animal to the best that it could be, you know, the best way it can be presented? And, you know, it's nice to see, like, Tyler over here, the Holstein, because he works with his brother.
Oh, really?
Oh, yeah. And Rebecca was in here earlier, and that's his sister. So it's getting passed on from expert right on through in the same barn.
And who knows whether these kids will go on to college. I'm sure some of them will.
A lot of them will. They'll go on to college for something at some point in time. But usually through the senior year, it's like, I'm not going to college. And then the last month, you know, all of a sudden, Tyler's going to go down to Morrisville for dairy.
Oh, really?
Yep. Oh. Down there for herd management.
So, great school, Morrisville.
Yep, and I've got some contacts there, and we'll make some phone calls.
You got to do what you can to help, right?
Every little bit helps, you know, whether it's Cobleskill or Oswego or Cornell.
Yep.
Every little bit helps.
Is there a time limit on this, or do they just go until he says I've had it?
It's at the discretion of the judge.
Oh, it is.
Yep. Because you'd rather go long, and it's, you know, more thorough, especially at this level. He might do a preliminary lineup. He might pull one out and switch them around. But it's just kind of.
So the kids know pretty well what to expect, though, right?
Oh, absolutely. Absolutely.
I've seen times, Don, where like at the county fair, where the judge had them line up. Somebody relaxed. All of a sudden, the judge says, all right, go around again. Yep. And somebody else moves into that spot. You don't relax until the judge says it's over.
Is that the way it goes?
That's one of them. You always keep your eyes on the judge. You know, that's the other thing. Because you got to make sure you're doing what he wants. You know, he may just give hand signals and not say anything.
But when he comes here, he comes for the whole day. He's the only judge, right?
He's the only judge for everything, yep.
Has he been here before?
Not while I was here.
I can't remember seeing him before.
He's a new face, but his wife runs the open show at the county fair, Wanda Emmerich.
Oh, no kidding.
And that's how we kind of got to him.
Do they live in this area, do you think?
Yep, they do. They live, she works up at Miners.
Oh.
So there's a connection up there, and usually I call her up to find a judge, and I was like, well, is Jerry available?
Yeah,
I'll just give you a cell phone number, and that's how that's started.
Here we go. Well, we don't have to worry about rain today. Just beautiful.
No, it's
beautiful clear skies and sunshine. And
we can't beat this.
Looks like we got three or four days. Of course, you know, stick around if you don't like the weather. It's going to change.
20 minutes.
Well, I think we're good for several days now with temperatures in the 80s, a couple of days. And this time of year, people are wondering whether they should put their gardens in yet. And farmers are trying to get in their fields. And we had a torrential downpour within the last 24 and 48 hours, but here we are. Ground's pretty nice and dry here today.
Yep. This is a good spot.
You couldn't have picked a better date.
No, we got lucky, you know.
This shindig, that's for sure.
Definitely got very lucky. The past few years, we've had real good luck with weather. And
yeah.
Can't beat it. This is where they go through and they switch out on the animals, and they got to go through and do the inspection of the animal they're going to be leading. And it's to, like, if one animal is giving them a little bit of a hard time, it's to find out, is the animal or is it the handler, you know? And
oh, I see.
That's what separates them out.
Well, they're a team, aren't they? They are a team.
And every once in a while, a judge will pick up a little sawdust and sprinkle it,
back.
Sprinkle it on the animals, see if the new guy picks it up.
Yeah. I didn't notice that.
Depending on who the judge is, you know, it depends on how everybody responds to him. Because each judge is looking for something a little slightly different. Usually it's all the same thing, but... But I really like Jerry as a judge. He's very thorough.
Well, I know nothing about him, but I'm very impressed.
He's not rushing. It's very thorough. He's taking his time.
Now, will there be more? I understand we're taking a lunch break after this. Will there be more judging this afternoon? Or
It'll be on the actual animals themselves. Confirmation will start in about 20 minutes after we get done here. It gives time to just, you know, recharge and start the second half.
So all the animals here will get judged then at that time?
Yep.
Or?
Yep. So, you've got some people that brought 10 animals.
Oh,
so,
that's true, too, yes.
So they got to get them in all the different classes. Sometimes you got two or three of your own animals going, and you got other people to hold, you know, lead them for you. And,
yep, absolutely.
But absolutely beautiful.
Nice to see some of the parents show up for this. That's nice, too.
We have an amazingly strong, parent, group of people. Anytime you call them, they're right there in a heartbeat. You know, just, what do you need? And it makes things like this actually possible, because without that, there's no way one person could pull this off.
There just aren't very many shows like this. You say there aren't very many in northern New York anymore?
This is the only one left in Clinton County. And, a lot of it is it's not the cheapest program to run in the world, but the kids definitely get a lot out of it.
Oh, there's no question about it. Look at how they've succeeded,
And I can see each of these kids competing at the state level in the next 5 years and taking it,
Okay.
You figure with this show, the county fair, the open show at the county fair, and then some of them actually go to Malone, they get four times in a year, whereas other places only get one. So over 2-3 years, they've showed 10 more times than everybody else in the state.
Isn't that amazing?
And it's just nice,
What I learned from Homer and others and you is that the kids learn how to speak publicly.
Yeah,
what they do, that's a very important fact.
Yeah, they do public speaking, prepared speeches. And this year I haven't done too much of that because most of that stuff we do in the winter, and it's a long drive from Saranac Lake. Yeah. So public speaking, prepared speaking, interviewing skills. Real world skills is going to get somebody a job.
Yeah, of course. It's the name of the game.
Yeah.
This is great to watch. Beautiful animals.
Group of young showmen. Again, let's show our appreciation. Outstanding young people. And it's really a tough class. We have our two novice who maybe don't have quite as much experience, but sorted themselves out in their class. And then our four, the two juniors and the two seniors. And to me, it was fairly tight placing in this class at the very top. But I've left one individual in the middle of the ring. And this is your master showman for 2012. Congratulations.
Tyler who?
Tyler Nephew.
Oh, wonderful. I could see that coming.
Yeah, he's got a lot of ring time.
Oh, yeah, beautiful animal.
Yeah.
That's great. He wears that ribbon well.
We go to the county fair and state fair and hang off all of your pocket days.
Really?
Oh, yeah.
Oh, that's great.
Yeah.
We're now taking a 20-minute break. After that 20-minute break, in the ring will be the Holstein Spring Calf Class.
Superintendent Laura Marlowe, how are you?
Good, and how are you today? I can always count. I know, right?
You got a direct line somewhere.
I know.
Could it be a better day?
No.
For this event?
No, we're so thrilled for the students and the animals, and it's just perfect. Not too hot for them and not too cold. So one of our funnest times of the year, and I can always count on seeing you here.
You know, we're delighted to be here, and we wouldn't miss it for the world, because these programs are relatively rare, especially here in the northeast corner of New York State, the only program left in Clinton County.
It's true.
So to get this many kids, many parents, farmers, just friends who drop by, teachers.
Oh, yes.
Involved. This is pretty special for me.
Oh, yeah. And we're so happy, you know, with budget cuts, that we didn't have to, you know, sacrifice our FFA program, because we feel it's the core of the school. FFA program, the agricultural program, it builds such good leadership skills in these kids. And we love it.
I won't ask you what kind of a year it's been. It's so hard every year, isn't it?
I don't know
how you do it.
It's tough, you know. You just try and be very mindful of the needs of the taxpayers, and you also have to provide good quality educational programs. And I'm happy to say we've been able to do both and have a 0% tax increase.
Don't you love it?
I love it.
It's so nice to have the almost universal support.
Oh yes.
Of this school community, as we call it, the central school system here.
Oh yes.
People love their school.
Oh yes. And this was very evident in our overwhelming the way our budget vote passed.
So this was just a few days ago, as the crow flies backwards, because we're doing this on May 18th, 2012.
Yes.
And as we mentioned earlier, this budget passed pretty easily, and we were very happy to see that.
It did, and it just, again, is a good show of support from our community and the pride they take in their education in their school.
So what's in the future?
Well, we're going to hopefully continue to do what we're doing. We have a new ag teacher coming on board. I think we'll be speaking to her soon.
And yes, we will.
And we hope to be bigger and better.
At this time, we'd like to present Mr. Jones with a present.
That's
you
great.
Made him.
Thanks so much
Thank
for talking with us.
Nice seeing you.
Have a great day.
You
will
too.
Give
him a present here.
Okay.
You.
He knew something was happening. This Don Jones getting a presentation from the kids. Look at that. Isn't that beautiful? Thanks for being a great junior FFA advisor, and all the kids signed it. I love it.
Okay. It was Justin, and it's all your fault. Well, you know, everybody in the school knew what this was.
Everybody but you.
Because we had to find it.
There you go.
That's wonderful. And for those people who just tuned in, that Don will be leaving, hopefully heading back to his hometown in the High Peaks area in Saranac Lake, and finding a new job and a new chapter in his life. Karen LaBumba.
Hi.
Welcome aboard.
Thank you.
That's a North Country name, so you must be a North Country girl.
I am, yes.
From right around here?
From here, yes. From up in Merrill. Armin and Brenda LaBombard are my parents.
Oh, there you go. So where did you went to school where?
I went to school here at Northern Adirondack. I'm a graduate from here, and I went to SUNY Cobeskill for my bachelor's and my master's at Oswego.
Were you looking forward to having this position at some point in your life, or
yes,
how did that happen?
At some point in my life, yes, I was looking forward to this position.
So now you're beginning when? For the next school year?
July 1st I start.
Oh boy. What goes on in the summertime?
Camp Oswegatchie, Clinton County Fair, state fairs, all that fun stuff.
People might think that after this wonderful ag show for the FFA, here in Northern Adirondack Central School, and after school is out in June, then it's all over, but it ain't over.
It's not over.
Well, when you think that these kids will be showing at the fair, some in Malone, some in Plattsburgh, right?
Yes.
And then state.
Then state fair.
And then federal, national, some of them?
Yes, some of them.
Have you shown cattle in your lifetime?
Yes, I have.
Tell me about it.
I've shown cattle since I was very little. I was on dairy judging teams in college and gone to Madison and Kentucky and done very well.
No kidding. I love it. Well, you don't live on a farm now, do you?
No, my parents just sold the cows.
Oh,
and
did?
But the farm is full of cows still. They're renting it out.
You know, we followed the fate of North Country Farms, family farms, over and over through the years, and it kills me to see the beautiful North Country Farms closing and going out of business, but it's the way it is today, you know?
Unfortunately.
It's hard to survive. It's hard to survive. Well, what do you look forward to here? This is old home week for you, then. You're very familiar with all of this. What year did you graduate?
I graduated in 1993.
Did you really?
Yes.
You went on to bigger and better things and then turn around. You know, they say what goes around comes around, right?
Yes, I'm very excited to be coming home.
Have you watched this program for a while?
Yes, I have.
Did you say you were part of the program when you were in high school?
Yes, I was.
Oh, so you know Homer Boucher, as we call him.
Yes, he was my ag teacher. And he's the reason I'm who I am today.
That's wonderful. So you look forward to a good year. We just talked with the superintendent. We're so thrilled and delighted that this program is going to be around for a while.
I am also.
Yeah. You look forward to some good things. How about next fall? Anything special?
We'll get together with the kids over the summer and plan a program of activities and go from there. Hopefully we'll have a whole bunch of things planned.
You know a lot of these parents, a lot of these kids already.
Yes.
You know, sometimes you grab a shoe and it doesn't quite fit for a while, but this shoe looks like a perfect fit for you, Karen.
Well, thank you.
Yeah. So how big a commute will you have?
I'll live right up in the Merrill area, so about 10-15 minutes.
Not hard to take.
Not hard to take.
No. You don't have to worry about the traffic situation.
Not too much traffic here.
But yeah. Well, isn't it great? I mean, how could this be a better day?
It's a beautiful day for the fair.
The weather is beautiful. The kids are great. The animals are fabulous. We've done some fun interviews. And we just love to watch these kids enjoying themselves. And it pleases me to see what these kids have learned since they were little kids, especially in this last judging, a few minutes later. And there's more, what's to come later?
The different classes are coming later for the rest of the afternoon. The different age classes are coming later on.
I see you right in there with the microphone, keeping all the notes and keeping things going. We're fortunate to have a very good judge today also.
Yes, he's a great judge today.
Yeah. I'm glad to see they fed him lunch anyway.
Yeah, keeps him happy.
Karen, it's such a pleasure for me to meet you.
It's a pleasure for me to meet you also.
And we can't wait to see what you'll have for us next year at this time.
Great, thank you.
Good luck with everything you do.
Thank you.
See ya. Another country heard from. He's the only one here that's taller than his cow. What's your first name?
Tyler.
Tyler Trombley.
Nephew.
Nephew. It takes me a while to catch up. So tell me about how that felt out there just a few minutes ago.
It felt pretty good.
Yeah.
Winning my senior year.
Well, you had a lot of experience.
Yeah, quite a bit.
Tell me a little bit about the past.
Well, started in sixth grade, and I won showmanship for the first time in seventh grade. And after that, I've been winning almost every year. And I just took third in a national show at Syracuse.
Did you really? Ooh.
In April?
That's a month or so ago.
Yeah. Yeah, it was about a month ago.
Yeah, I was going to say he's going to do it till he gets it right, but it sounds to me like he's had it right for a long, long time. Tell people who are watching this program or don't know anything about cattle judging, how much training you need, how long you have to spend with your animals, what you have to learn.
It takes a lot of practice. Luckily I had my uncle and my mother to show me most of the tricks. don't know, it just takes a lot of practice and somebody that knows what to do and to show you how to get you started going.
Yeah. So how about to tell me a little bit about that animal you brought today? You brought more than one though, right?
Yeah, we got six here.
Just a half a dozen?
That one is a five-year-old. Her name's Linda.
Oh, right, Linda. She was beautiful. She was outstanding.
I took her to Syracuse this spring.
Oh, did you really?
Yeah. And she was second junior and 13th open in the
national.
In the national show.
Isn't that neat? Isn't that neat? That's so good. So what's next now for you? Besides getting out of school.
Why is he smiling like that? I'm thinking about going to Morrisville for data science, yeah.
Lots of people are. Lots of kids in your class will be going to Morrisville if I got my guess right.
Yeah, a couple.
Really?
Yeah.
Right, I don't know how many will be going to Cornell, but we got some Coble Skill, we got some good schools in New York.
Yeah.
Have you been to Morrisville?
Yeah, I went down there for a visit last fall.
Did you?
Yeah.
You liked it?
Very nice. Nice barn, nice parlor.
You haven't applied?
Yeah, I applied.
Oh, you did? And were accepted?
Not yet.
Come on, I'm going to call them up as soon as the camera stops. What's the matter with those people? You will be. Is that the only place you applied?
Yeah.
It better work then, right?
Yeah, hopefully.
That's great. Well, what you've done here is pretty special. We recorded your big smile. Linda had a big smile too, yeah. So you know. And what, you got something here that I wanted to take a look at. It's a magazine called the New York Holstein News, right?
Yeah.
I'd never heard of it before, but anybody that has Holsteins has heard of it, right?
Right. So it's the publication by New York Holstein Association. And two months a year, they sent to a national convention. The book for going to national, for statewide, people statewide. It was in Madison the following year, and this year, the next month, it'll be going to Missouri.
Well, this one, even upside down, looks like it came to your brother, right?
Yeah.
he ran right up to us the minute we got here. Open it up. I want to see that. I want to take a look at the articles. He obviously knew that was going to be in there.
Yeah.
Look at this. Huh? It's a nice article in it. Did you read the whole thing?
Yeah, I read it.
You better have. Because apparently they went around and interviewed several of the farms in the northeast corner of the state,
yes,
right?
Yes. This is our yearly inspection for the year for Northern New York.
Oh, it is?
Yes. They do a section in the state every month.
Oh, they do?
Yes. And this happened. That issue is our Northern issue. Next issue will be the Southwest.
Well, when did you guys find out that this was going to be in here?
In February.
Really?
Yes. We Mike Patrick called up, wanted to put an ad in the Holstein News for regional magazine. We said yes. And it happened to be a red and white issue, too, so we had to put a red and white kill on it on top of it.
Which
is his kill, Squirrel. She's been grand champion here in school fair and plastic fair a couple of years in a row. She's home and dry now. She's resting for this summer circuit.
I think your picture of you should have been a lot bigger than that, Tyler, don't you? I mean, come on.
I don't know. I think the picture of the cows is better.
Oh, you're a very modest guy. That's wonderful to have that article in there.
And the two Holstein cows are his, too, also.
It's, oh, are they really?
Yeah. The older cow, Max, Hilda, she's 2E Excellent 91. She's just on the top breeding of cows. We got some classified excellent.
No kidding.
And there's a daughter. And she's a good plus 83 or 84, Tyler.
83.
Mother, daughter.
Yes.
Don't you love it?
And she had, daughter's a good future, too. Her daughter will be excellent in a few years down the road, but she's only a 2-year-old. This picture's taken. And the cow is a 5-year-old. The picture's taken. So
I love it.
And you can see the confirmation right there. And the older cow is 6 generations excellence behind her.
Isn't that amazing? North Country, there you are,
yeah,
right there.
Country, yeah.
I love it.
Too.
Huh?
There's another page, too.
Find the other page there. We got
27.
Oh, you remember the number of the page?
I showed somebody else earlier. This is where the article starts at our farm.
Oh, yeah. Might as well show it to people. Right over here.
This is North Star Acres, which is prepared for our dairy farm. Which has been the farm name for now for 50 years since I've been showing.
Oh, are you kidding me?
Yeah, we started to appreciate from my side showing. North Star Acres. They keep around through the family, so.
Might as well keep the family tradition going.
My sisters and brothers all showed North Star Acres. My daughter showed North Star Acres. Now, my nephews, showing on North Acres.
Right.
And a few more years, my grandsons will be showing on North Acres.
I love it.
And there's a picture of Hilt Linda, 34th article.
We're looking. I know it's in there. It's like me trying to find the right hymns in the hymn book on Sunday morning.
Right here's the picture.
Oh, there we go.
Linda, of course, went circles in spring in April.
Uh-huh.
And the heifer behind their background is senior yearly, well, winter yearly called now. I still call it senior yearly class. And she's took me to September, and she placed sixth in the junior show in the national in the spring. It's a junior, and eighth.
14th open.
Oh, beautiful.
She's here today.
Oh, she's here also?
Yes.
So have you got more judging to go on this afternoon? What happens for you this afternoon, Tyler?
Hopefully win at least grand champion.
At least? I mean, you don't want much, right?
No, you don't want much. You must be the top dog in the show.
Why not?
Yeah.
It's something you look forward to. What do you see for yourself, say, about 10 years down the road? Where would you like to be?
I'd like to be milking in a bigger barn and freestyle with a parlor, hopefully. And have more registered Holsteins and showing at more shows.
You like Holsteins. People are partial to the kind of cattle they have.
Yes, they are. My brother, when he was showing, he had jerseys, Nash ears. And my other best brother said, show the Holsteins in the family. But my brother is the one who showed jerseys, Nash ears in the group.
Yeah. I've always been partial to Holsteins because that's the kind of cows we had on the farm I worked at all through high school.
Linda's going to make a record of 20,000 pounds of milk, over 20,000 pounds of milk, 3 to 5 day lactation. And her test is running at 4%, which is most high for Holstein. So she's a Jersey's running 4% test. She's got 1,200 pounds of fat in 3 or 5 days milk out through. She's a cow we flushed last year. The calf that Matt showed, his younger brother showed today, is a flush product. He's got other calf that will be out later on. It's the same flush of that same cow. Both sisters are here. Plus, she got heifer calf she dropped off in December with my grandson showing in Plattsburgh. So he's got a good long family. Linda's L family starting the barn. They're all sort of L's and the H family, Hilda, and he's got that his good daughter here. So he's got good stock to start off with if you're excited to keep in the farmery.
Now if we could just get milk prices up there where they belong.
That's right. If you have milk prices where they belong, we can make a nice living. We don't ask for much, it's pretty cool.
You know, it's something we've talked about off and on, Calvin and I, since I started doing this show with him 15 years ago or more. You know, you watch the prices go down the tubes, then you watch them come back a little bit and you start crowing, then they go back down again.
Yeah. It's all the supply and demand market, and if it takes away some of the supply from Europe for the cheeses and bring over here, the milk price in the United States will go up or real quick. I don't think we need a quota like they got in Canada. The quota is nice over there, but they are in problems with their quotas also because they're short of milk right now, so they buy milk from the United States.
Yeah.
So no matter what,
amazing.
It's amazing how things work out.
Yeah.
It's just that things work different ways.
They certainly do. Congratulations, young man.
Thank you.
Maybe we'll get to congratulate you again when it's all over this afternoon, but it's a perfect May 18th here at Northern Adirondack Central School. We love it, and it's a pleasure to see you.
Thank you.
You guys have a great day, will you?
Thank you. Now. Have a good day.
Keep smiling. See ya.
Thank
Be good. That was a very, very nice presentation the kids made.
Yes, it was.
I love to watch them running around buzzing, talking to themselves. He doesn't really know. He doesn't really
know.
No,
they had me going for probably about 3 weeks.
Isn't that beautiful?
I think they brought every teacher down to see what they were doing. And
but the best part of it is it shows that they really care, Don.
Absolutely. That's a badge of honor.
That makes you feel good, doesn't it?
Absolutely.
Well, you got to hang it in a prominent place now.
Yep. If I have to, I'll build another wall in my house somewhere. That'll be there somewhere.
This is a great program here. I mean, you know, you've spent some time at it. You've worked really hard night and day thinking about it and doing it. And I know you wish it well in the future as well, even though you won't be here.
Well, I feel a lot better knowing that Karen's going to be here. And she's got a track record with, you know, from the area, but also building programs.
You know, when we watch... I mean, this sounds like a broken record for me because I watch people hire for different positions, no matter where it is, and it seems as though there's always somebody locally who's qualified and they're overlooked and somebody's brought in from Cucamonga or some other state or province, and it doesn't always please me to see that happen. But in this case, it's very nice because it'll be a smooth transition.
Oh, absolutely.
Yes. You will get a great job up there.
Something's going to work out.
I'll holler loud enough so they'll always hear me, Don. So. But at least you'll be home taking care of that wonderful family.
I'll be with my family.
You'll have a nice, peaceful summer, we hope.
Yeah, sure.
Yeah.
I'll find something. I've never collected unemployment, and I'm not going to start now.
Neither have I.
If my legs are able to bend and my arms are...
You'll do it.
Band, we'll find
you'll
something.
Do it. You'll have a summer of good health, and that counts more than anything
I'll
else.
I'll be able to go to my kids' soccer games.
Yeah, don't you love it?
Yeah.
You won't miss any of that stuff?
No.
Yeah. Well, Don, thanks so much for everything, and thanks for talking with us today.
No problem.
We love this. I hope they fed you well.
Yes, they did.
Did they give you some lunch?
Yes, I've had lunch.
I heard you say anything you bring is fine with me.
Sure,
you're so easy
fine.
To get along with. I forgot your name already.
Jerry Emmerich.
Jerry Emmerich, it's so wonderful to meet you here.
Well, this is first time I've been here. I honestly didn't know much about it, and I was called by Mr. Jones, the ag instructor, and asked if I would judge the show, and glad that I did.
You're very, very good at it. I don't know much about cattle judging, although Calvin and I have done shows here every single year. But it's takes something, a special ingredient, which you obviously have. You were so kind to the kids. You worked the audience real fine, and it's got to be a real kick for you at this stage in your life.
Well, I grew up on a dairy farm, showed cattle in 4-H and FFA.
Did you really? Where?
In Western Ohio is where I'm from originally. And I think it's, you want to treat kids the way you want to be treated. And that's with respect.
It still applies.
And also, hopefully they'll take something home that helps them later in life. And the other thing is, as I mentioned, like when I did the Master Showman, I kind of actually peeled them off and left one animal in the ring. One thing I think we miss slightly is whether or not we actually entertain the crowd enough. If people come out to watch the show, we want them to be entertained and still evaluate the animals at the same time. So sometimes I do a few little different things.
I love it. And it was well accepted and everybody cheered, and that's the way it ought to be.
And it was actually quite a good group of young kids showing. They've all been, as I mentioned in my reasons, obviously it's should congratulate not only them, but their parents and their instructors, because they've been well trained. And that's I've judged different shows, different areas, and there are just different levels of competency or experience, and this would rank quite high.
You know, watching some of these kids and reading about their the accolades and the things that they've done and on the state and national level, I'm very impressed.
Yes, I honestly don't know the kids over here necessarily, but from what I could hear around the ringside was that some of these youth have participated in not only local but regional and national programs and have been very competitive.
We're so careful to spend a lot of time promoting this ag program and all the other ag programs. I think it's so important for this community and for all the others.
What we find, and I work in agribusiness, and what we find is the disconnect among the average consumer in the country and agriculture today. When you have about 1% of the workforce involved in food production today, which agriculture is, of course, food production. If we can actually educate our kids to be ambassadors for agriculture, because one of the things that a lot of us feel we really need to in the future put more emphasis on is educating the consumer how their food is grown.
So important in this day and age.
Yes.
You have had some international experience judging. Tell me about it.
Grew up on a dairy farm in Western Ohio, graduated from Ohio State University in dairy science. have worked for the same company for 29 years, Select Sires, based out of Central Ohio, and actually one of my, for the first 10 years of my career, I was based at our headquarters near Columbus, Ohio, and actually worked in international marketing for 10 years, and traveled probably two-thirds of the world, and spent most of my time in Latin America.
Did you really?
Yep.
How was it?
I would say that a young college kid, probably Latin America might not have been the first place in the world that you may have wanted to travel to, but after traveling there for 10 years, there are some just beautiful spots. And Latin America is so different from the north to the south, such diverse cultures. I actually enjoyed the very southern part of South America, Chile, Argentina, Brazil, which is a whole different culture than what we think of, say, like Mexico. It entirely different. Beautiful.
Have you been back?
Oh, yeah. And last time I judged a show in Brazil about 4 years ago. It's the last time I was down there. I was just actually in Denmark in Europe 3 weeks ago, and looking at the Danish Jersey cattle. And so still like to travel once in a great while, not as much as I used to, but
it's an experience. Where's home right now for you?
My wife Wanda and I live in Moores, New York.
Just a fur piece down the road.
Just a fur piece, yeah, about 20 minutes from here.
Far from here.
We have a 60-acre kind of gentleman's farm.
Yeah, that's the best kind.
And we raise cattle. That's kind of our weekend hobby.
Isn't that wonderful? Yeah. That's great. Well, it's a pleasure to meet you.
Okay.
Thank you so much for being here.
You're welcome.
We really appreciate the care you take with these kids. It shows.
See
you later. Have a great day.
Thanks.
Sunshine, we still have the sunshine. Is this beautiful?
We are lucky today, aren't we? This is absolutely gorgeous. We couldn't have asked for more.
18th of May, 2012, Northern Adirondack Central School for the Ag Day, the FFA Ag Day. I forgot your name already.
Mr. Locke, Mike Lockman.
Yes, Michael, good to see you again.
From
Morrisonville, of course.
Up the street from you.
Did you see the fire this morning?
No, I did not.
Oh, big fire right near my house.
Uh-oh. A
couple of houses down. I don't know. 8 o'clock, maybe?
I was already gone.
Oh, you were gone?
I was already here.
Oh, you were?
8 o'clock, we're working.
I left a little bit after about 20 after 9. Streets were all blocked off, so
I had to go
around Emory Street and back up Mason Street.
I'll have to check the neighbors and see what happened.
Unfortunately, I think it's a two-family home.
Oh.
And there'll be some people who
on your side of the street or the other side?
On our side of the street, but east of us.
Okay.
A couple of houses.
Towards my house.
Yeah.
All right.
Two family house.
Okay.
I forgot who the owner is, but I don't think anybody was seriously injured. They had ambulances there, and I know one went to the hospital, so we'll see what happened when I get home.
Okay, well,
I hope
everybody's okay.
Yeah, so what's going on with you here?
Well, we are in the middle of a busy, busy year. We've got our building project going on.
And I noticed that when I got here.
Yeah,
I had forgotten that.
We're at the end of this year, we're halfway through, so I'll be looking forward to the finish of that. But, you know, the contractors have been great. The building construction managers have kept us informed, kept things moving forward. So, yeah, it's been a busy year with all that going on. And as you can see, we've moved the Ag Fair from the back side by the...
I like it over here, you know.
I do, too. Actually, I think next year, I've already been thinking for next year. Yes, I have. I think next year, actually, we'll move the tents back about 50, 60 yards, and we'll have what's behind the tents in front, so you come in and see all that, and a little more of a midway space, and then we'll have the show in the back. So, yeah, I think... It was a good move to do it up here. I think it's actually a better move to have it here, but we'll make some improvements.
New and improved.
New and improved.
2013.
You can always do better, can we not?
Well, you couldn't have ordered a better day than we had today.
I will never complain about this weather.
Everybody's having a good time. Miles and miles of smiles.
Yes.
Wonderful cattle judging going on all day.
Yep.
The other kids with the arts and crafts and various things going on.
Yeah, we got a lot of projects from around the building. Yep.
It's always a big kick to come down here, you know it?
Well, we're the last school in Clinton County with an FFA. So it's such a unique program. And we have like so many kids where their families show up. And I mean, you know, it's a family event, you know. I mean, like all of the kids bring, you know, their parents are here supporting them. And they're getting, you know, this is their preparation for the Clinton County Fair, and if they do well there, they move on to the state fair. So yeah, it's just a part of the process.
It's so great to see parents supporting this program, because without that, it could never survive.
Well,
the budget vote recently proves that they want things to go. They want to maintain the status quo up here.
Well,
that's a good thing.
The board and Mrs. Marlowe did an excellent job on that budget, and there was no reason, you know, there was nothing to fight over, you know what I mean? It was just a great, great, great budget, and we did, you know, we managed to keep almost everybody here and everything, so, you know, no big cuts or anything. So, I mean, they need to be commended, because it was a really good budget in the middle of all of what's going on everywhere else. You know, we're still in the middle of this building project, so I mean, we're pretty lucky up here. We're doing well.
What's going to happen when the building project is complete? What are they doing? Adding?
We are getting 10 new classrooms, a new gymnasium.
No kidding. A new gym.
The philosophy behind the whole project is to establish a middle school in the building. And we've mixed middle school and high school for many years. And when Mrs. Marlowe came here, I think it was right before she came here, they had done a survey about how could we improve the school, and the whole middle school concept and philosophy Mrs. Ross has been pushing for a number of years. And so Mrs. Ross, the middle school principal, is going to be here to see her middle school established. And so there will be 10 new classrooms, a renovation to the A-wing, part of the A-wing, so that we have a whole middle school concept that's separate from the high school, a middle school gym that separates the middle school students from the high school students for gym. Just establish what's developmentally appropriate for those kids in that time, you know. And so it's a huge, huge, huge philosophical change to the school and physical change to the school, and it's going to be a great addition.
Can't wait to see when it's finished next year.
I can't wait. Next year. Yeah, we're halfway through this year, so it's great, great change.
I love it.
Yeah.
You're the best. Thanks so much.
Thank you so much.
Have a great day.
It's wonderful seeing you here. Take care.
You know, there's a phrase that says the road to hell is paved with good intentions. Well, we had good intentions, Don, to talk to, what's his name, Matt Carter?
Matt Carter, yeah.
But he's a little bit
camera shy. He's a little camera shy. And
so he's showing cattle all day today, but we wanted to mention him anyway.
Yep.
Because you said he did good things.
He did a lot of good things. Last year at the state fair, he won first place in the FFA Dairy Showmanship. And that earned him a place to go to Nationals. And at Nationals, he got the only gold emblem in New York State for any contest. So he deserves a lot of credits. And that's not because of me. That's because of Mr. Bushy working with him and, you know, all the extra time outside of school that he puts in.
A lot of ingredients in every bowl of soup. Don't forget that. I want to congratulate you for all of your good work here.
Thank you.
Can't wait to see what the next chapter of your life reveals, but it'll be good things for you.
It'll definitely be good. You know, and don't be surprised you get a phone call to cover something.
We're ready. Thanks a lot, Don.
All right, thanks.
Thank you. Thank you so much to all of our viewers, to all these people responsible for any phase of this operation today, and Matt's mother for helping to make the food across the way. We almost got over there to interview her. Thanks to Calvin for carrying the camera. Thanks always for your comments, your suggestions, and more important than that, for your generous checks made out to Hometown Cable, care of Calvin Castine on the Ridge Road in Champlain. And who knows where we're going to